Welcome to Fresh Cut Grass,
the number one show for grassroots and Sunday League football.
Here's what we have for you today.
When they play the dons, they play the dons!
Play the dons!
Completely annihilated them.
Oh, man.
Oh, with an absolute worldie.
Cup final madness.
Hey, I feel like I should be wearing a suit or something.
Hey, it's safe to say that we have all the emotions of a cup final coming up, so don't go anywhere.
Hey, this might be the best episode yet.
Let's go.
This is Fresh Cut Grass! Come on! Hey, let's get this party started. Now, last week we showed you how the SE Dons had made it to the final of the George Harley Cup.
Well, the final was last weekend and saw the Dons take on FC Cortez for one of the most anticipated finals this season.
Hey, listen, man, the Dons were fired up for this one, as it was about more than just silverware.
Here's how they got on.
So it's that midfield battle again. Ryan Palmer coming out on top. He knocks it past his geezer. Put him off, who knows? He's collected the ball, he's travelling towards goal. Can he get a shot off? It's King now on the overlap. He's knocked it through to Nathan Palmer. He's through on goal. It's a family day today. We've got all our family. We've got all our friends. Our supporters don't even call them fans. It's a fantastic turn.
Turn it around, not me. Turn it around. Oh. When play the dons, they play the dons. Longest night, we guarantee it.
Play the dons.
Yeah. Even better touch. Can he compose himself? Yeah.
Champion.
Champion. Ole, ole, ole.
Champion. Champion. Ole, ole, ole. Come on. Hey, listen. I love the Dons, mate. And I absolutely love Cup Final Day.
Listen, man, we all know that the Dons are about their family. That's what they call their supporters. So I would like to introduce to you guys the main man himself, Dom Strapzy. And of course, Mitch. Hey. How's it going, bro?
How you doing, bro? You good? Yeah.
What are you saying, man?
Good to see you. Good to see you, man.
Good to see you, Mitch.
You good?
Nice one.
Nice to see you, bro. Awesome stuff, man.
Man. Champions in that, yeah?
I don't even know what to say, brother. That's exactly what we are still, I'm not going to lie.
I'm just looking at you, bruv. Like, yeah. You look like you've been ready, bruv. You look like you've been working out, listen, the both of you.
Nah, bruv. I need to get back, especially looking at you, man. Anyway, yeah. I need to get back in the gym. But nah, man, it feels good, bro. It feels good. It was a long journey. Mm-hmm. 4 years this club's been going, so
wow.
We finally got silverware in front of a record crowd as well. Like, it was a great day, man.
What did it mean? What did it mean, not just to you lot, yeah, but to the entire team? Like,
everyone's been on our journey. First 2 years, we were just mates just mucking around on the Sunday pitch. The last couple of years, we started filming our stuff. We didn't really plan for anything. We just started filming it because everyone loves Sunday League, so that's what we did. And when it got to the cup final and seeing 500, 600, 700 people there for the sake of just Sunday League football, right, mate. Passion in that.
It's mad. And like for the boys, like obviously we've got people that play on Saturdays as well. But that Saturday stuff means nothing compared to this. Like, it's our brothers, you know what I'm trying to say? Yeah. So, yeah, it's amazing, man. Proper.
That's awesome stuff. Like, I saw, like you said, loads of people came out. It was a big final.
Yeah.
Talk us through the game in your perspective, man.
Bruv, like, obviously, we took it dead serious. Real serious. We came there in suits, everything, you know what I'm trying to say.
Wow. Real deal.
You know what kind of picture you had in your pocket.
Yeah.
We said, we're not losing this game. There was a deeper meaning to this one, you know what I'm trying to say. Like, we had to win this game. So, and Cortez won our league the year before.
See, they're not talking now no more. Remember that last game, all the talk they had?
They beat us in the league this year. So we was expecting a tough game, but we were just dead serious, and we believe when we're switched on, there's nobody that will beat us, because we don't. It's not an option to lose. It went perfect to plan.
Mentally and physically.
And verbally.
And verbally, completely annihilated them, start to finish. From the moment, if you've seen the episode, when they come out of that dressing room, you can see on their faces.
They're beaten. Imagine, what is it about Cortez that you lot got a little, you know what I mean?
You don't have a hatred for no one. It's just a football banter, that's all it is. They came to our ground, they earned the right to boast in front of us. We just did the same thing on a Sunday.
You look like you wanted to say something else. Like, you look like when he said it, he went.
Nah, you know what it is, yeah? Obviously, there's rivals in our league, man. you know, Cortez beat us that one time and they was all celebrating in front of us. They said, like, cool, man, you earned the right. Yeah. We'll see you again soon. And we saw them again. And I'm like, it is what it is, man. It is what it is. Yeah, it is what it is, man. But at the same time, like Mitchell said, we ain't got no hatred to nobody. Like, we shake your hand after the game, but we take it dead serious, man. Like, we take it too serious. I'm not gonna lie, we do, you know what I mean? But that's just how we are. That's how we treat life. I take life serious, bro, you know what I mean? So on the pitch, it's warfare. And we won and we celebrated in front of them. And yeah, man, it is what it is, man.
Hey, brands, like they said, brands, they ain't got no problems with no one, so you can still approach the Dons, no problem. And of course, it was a great performance by the team, but were you confident, like, going into the match? Were you like, you know what, today is our day?
I think we prepared the night before, me, Big G and SK, up 3-4 in the morning, doing tactics.
Wow. For real, because what it is, we got some ballers in our team, man. Like, I'm just an average footballer, but I've got heart, you know what I mean? Now, me, Big G, SK, Mitchell, Ryan Palmer, we're the ones who kind of, well, Ryan Palmer's sick though, so he can do what he wants, innit? But like us, me, Big G and SK, we're the keynotes of the team. Like, we really lead the team and we do the dirty work. We always say to each other, we're gonna overwork and get underpaid. Yeah, that's what we do for the team, you know what I mean? And then them man do their thing and win games. But I was a little bit nervous about it, but I was confident, man. I knew we was gonna win, man. So.
But at what point did you not feel like in control of the game? When did you think, you know what? You've got this thing.
Personally, obviously, I'm on the sideline doing the GoPro in my head. From watching it, I think once we went 1-0 down, I know, 1-0 up, sorry. They're the only team in our league who, in my opinion, that can't actually play football. Generally play football. So once we went 1-0 up, they had to come out and they've got nothing going from there. So
they're a traditional Sunday league team. What they do, they pump it long and sit back. Mm. So they focus on counter attacks, but we just nullified them. It wasn't happening. So
you guys sorted that out in Mourinho tactics the night before. Yeah, like, we knew, they ain't got nothing. Yeah, all the X's and the boards. Okay,
they needed a plan B and they didn't have one. It was peak.
You know they're gonna see this, right?
I can't wait till they see it. Yeah. And we're playing them again in the league on Sunday.
Oh wow.
And I don't even want to go into it, but they've complained to the league.
Really?
They don't want us in the league. That's how we call it, they don't want us here.
Oh, okay.
They don't want us in the league. They've been in the league for 16 years.
Wow.
Yeah, and they don't want us in the league. We got pulled aside by the league because of them.
Wow.
I'm trying to say. So
what? Someone's talking. Someone's doing a lot of talking.
Man. Yeah, so.
Cortez, you lot need to
and
stop
talking.
And
we're playing them again in the league Sunday.
Yeah. And quickly, I know, did they beat Baiteze last time?
They did beat Baiteze.
Oh, okay.
But you know how it is, yeah?
Shout out to the producer. They beat Baiteze.
But the thing is, of course, like I said, the Cortez are not a rubbish team. That's what I'm trying to, and I say that on camera, like they're not. We just destroy them.
Yeah.
And I saw the way they beat Baiteze is they just bullied them.
Yeah.
Real talk, that's what they've done. They bullied Baiteze. Baiteze are better than Cortez.
Yeah, yeah.
But Baiteze seem to lack fight in their team, you know what I'm trying to say? Oh. And Cortez bullied Baiteze and went through.
Oh, man.
So you know what I'm trying to say? And that's how they beat teams.
Yeah.
They're physical.
Yeah.
And they try to get on you. And they work against Baiteze, it seemed to work. Because I watched that game.
Yeah,
I think this will be interesting.
Yeah, yeah.
But yeah.
Scouting.
But that's what I'm saying. That's what I like. That's what I like AC Barnes as well. Because look, listen, they play ball as well, but at the same time, they ain't going to be bullied.
No way.
You know what I mean? They're out here in the jungle.
Yeah.
But that's how Cortez win games. And like I said, it's a tactic, though. It's not. I don't mean bullies in Baiteze were scared.
Yeah, I know.
They turned it physical.
Yeah.
They got a 1-0 lead and just sat.
Yeah. Wow.
And invited Baiteze on and then just kept on touching him.
I think Baiteze got a culture shock when they played Cortez.
Yeah.
The reason why they lost. They're playing against full grown men.
Yeah.
And a lot of Baiteze, they're young boys. They're good players.
Yeah.
But they're playing against full grown men on a Sunday and on a Sunday that care about it probably a little bit more.
I think
they got a culture shock and that's the reason why they lost. Against us, stars make fights.
Yeah.
You can play ball and fit them with physical.
I came in here with the Tony Bellis. Hey,
we're saying that. Hey, listen. Next episode, you'll see it. I was saying that because we got a man sent off and we started shouting that Tony Bellew, no excuses.
Yeah. Like that. So there was a lot of goals going on, right?
Yeah, man.
Favourite goal on the day?
Zach Ansah, he received it on a Crave turn. Turn, banged it, bottom right.
Hey.
Different quality, man. Yeah, the ball, the lead up to it was just immense. Yeah. Sick.
That's awesome.
Like, you touched on like having X amount of people there, was it 500, 700 people there?
I think when they'd done it, it was just over 700.
Man.
And it ain't being done.
That's mad. Yeah. That's not actually, what was that like? What was that like? Because obviously you man get crowds anyway, but.
Yeah, it was amazing, bro. I've performed in front of crowds. And but not when I perform in front of crowds, usually it's people for other people as well, isn't it? Like,
yeah.
for all them people to be there for us, football, it was mad, bruv. It was amazing. It was emotional, it was still, because I was thinking, wow, man, you really have bought into our journey. Mm-hmm. There was a minute silence for my mum, you know what I'm trying to say, the whole crowd quiet. Yeah, respect to Cortez, because they pulled it. And bruv, it was amazing, man. So show how far we've come. This time last year, we was kicked out of the league. It's just, the journey's been mental. And it's all, and I keep going on, but it's all authentic.
Yeah.
It's just real authentic.
That's what people like about you, like I was saying. I was saying the camera used to be a little bit smudged last year.
Yeah,
you know, now they got a graphic.
Slap some dirt on it.
Yeah, a little bit. I remember like it was all shaky and that. Now we got a stand, like I'm like, one of the moving ones. But I want to say, what's next for Dons now? Because you guys are on the up at the moment. Yeah, you're going to have to, you know what this game is like?
Yeah, obviously we still got we can't win the league, but we've got a couple league games left. We're into our next final, but it's all politics going on at the moment. I don't think that will happen. We're playing against the Alberton and Bromley District League, so the whole league, we're playing a representative team. Mm-hmm. Pre-season's going to be nuts. We're just landing up at the moment. To be honest, I can't answer that question, man. Like, there's so much going on. I'm excited about it. I really think next year is going to be crazy.
On the pitch, I would say on the pitch, obviously better football, much more entertaining, and titles. Right. So come up against us. We'll shake hands before the game. We'll shake hands after the game. Whatever goes in between, don't take offense.
Yeah, man. For real, it's another one. You know what I'm saying? As we say, you want to play the Dons, play the Dons. You know when they won the league, you went like this.
Yeah.
I said that's it. It's done.
Done.
And this is Jackson. He's like, oh, Joe, mate. No, it's not done yet. Yeah.
But for you guys to be winning, like winning by so many goals, and you just kept going and
it's
going.
It's crazy.
Didn't because yeah. like what?
Went for the jugular, man.
You don't lose 7-0 in a cup final, man. You can't let that happen. I mean. Yeah, you know what I mean? You can't, man. You got to have more pride than that. So.
Yo, you said you ain't got beef, man. That beef's just about to sizzle up, bro, with a bit of oil, fam. You get me?
You said that we disrespected him, his players, his own players disrespected him.
His own players?
They were anemic. They were anemic the entire game.
How are you losing 7-0 in the fight? Some people can wonder how they got there.
He had his missus, his kids there.
Oh, man.
But, like, listen, it is what it is. We lifted the cup and. I just want to say I dedicated that cup to my mum. You know, she passed and that was all for her. That's what it meant to us. Like, we couldn't lose that game. Yeah, man, it's a family club, man. It's serious stuff, and next year we want everything. We want all the belts. We want to unify.
That's it. Unify the division, cuz. Unify the team. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Watch out, the Dons are coming. Huge, massive congratulations, man. Like you know, we were backing you guys the whole freaking way, man. And we can't wait to see what's next for the Dons, man.
Yeah, for real, man. And don't forget to show the Dons love on their social pages and all sorts, you know what I mean? I love the Instagram, you know what I mean? I'm a regular liker, a regular commenter. And if you want to see the highlights, make sure you head over to Don Strapzy TV, man. It's all over there, man. Go check it out. It's on our screens now. Well, go check it out after the show. Wait till this is done.
Hey Joe.
Yeah?
What's better than one cup final?
What?
Two cup finals, mate. Oh yes. Last week we saw Eltham SF take on the Odd Fellows Arms. Kind of sounds like a puff. In the final of the Wynn Jones Memorial Bowl. Can they retain their title?
Hey, here's how it went down.
Let's lift it! man that was agonizingly close to being one of the greatest comebacks I've ever seen in a cup final.
You know what, Dave? It wasn't quite meant to be for Eltham this season. Sorry, Manny, but they can be really proud of reaching the final and actually taking it to the opposition.
Absolutely, without a shadow of a doubt. But where do you think it went wrong for them?
You know what? I'm not sure. Let's take a look. Oh, man, they've got the ball again.
Oh, look at that.
Nobody didn't want to foul.
Nobody wants to put their foot in.
Mate, this is everyone's the box you're challenging.
Listen, man. You know what? Let's get number the keeper there, though.
Oh, man. You know what? It wasn't the goalkeeper's fault. It was a deflection. But they should have closed it down beforehand. Like, they were tippy-tappy and playing Arsenal football, yeah, in the box.
They were scared of getting a make it conceding the penalty, mate.
Yeah, sometimes you just got to get a foot in there. You know them ones there? Get in there, fam. You got, you know what I mean? Or you get that. That's what happens.
Yeah, either way, it gets a goal if you don't get involved, innit? That's what I'm saying. Dropping off the action there. Yeah. All right. Yeah. A nice play
there.
Oh, yeah. Nice.
That's what we want to see. Captain quality. Style.
Oi. Hey, listen. Captain is taking this. Get. Oh, yeah. Nice ball. Great ball.
Yeah.
Swings it in.
Oh,
yes. That's Nick it. Post. That's it. You know what I mean? But listen, it's a bit late though, isn't it?
No, there's still a bit of time though, Dave. You know what I mean? There's still a bit of time. But you know, at least they've got the spirit now. They're fighting again.
Yeah. Listen. You got to shout at captain though, because he took the game by the scruff of the neck.
Exactly.
You see what I'm saying? Put himself forward.
Mm-hmm. Kino.
Yeah.
1999 against Juventus.
Yeah, that's what we need
leg
to see. Exactly, you know what I mean?
I'm an Arsenal fan, mate. What do I know?
Okay. Ooh, long over throw.
Oh, look, can you see that touch?
Oh! Keeper saves it.
What's going on here? I don't know if that was a foul still.
Nah. You got the ball.
Oi! Oh! Roof of the net! Hey, hold on.
Now, Dave, did you see that? Eltham look much better, much stronger, organised when they're not trying to play the long ball over to Thomas, bro.
Hey, mate, listen. What's up with the Sam Allardyce football? Do you think it was Paul the manager, or do you think the player is on the field?
It's definitely Paul the manager. He's sitting there wearing a sideman hat, bro. I don't know what game he thought this was. You know what I mean? Nah, man, not good enough. And you know what? Like you said as well, right? They should not be waiting till the end of the game to be coming back.
Absolutely. Look, it's too little too late.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? It's a cup final. You're supposed to give it your all. Mm. You see what I'm saying? Play the ball on the floor, mate.
Those guys tried to turn up for 15 minutes, man. Not good enough. And hey, look, what did Manny say last time you saw him?
Hey, listen, Manny was like, hey, listen, stop talking smack about our team. Yeah. Listen, Manny, we'll stop talking smack about your team start playing football. You know what I'm saying? I don't know what was going on over there. It was an absolute shambles. You know what I mean? The Wynn Jones Memorial Bowl. I had to learn the words of that, yeah?
Yeah,
the Wynn Jones Memorial Bowl is supposed to be your title. It's supposed to be your trophy, all right? Fix up. All jokes aside, man, listen, we absolutely love Eltham SF, you know what I mean? Hard on you guys because we love you, all right? And we know that you guys got the techers, the skill, the determination, the heart, the pride, the passion, the verb to do some great stuff, you know what I mean? And plus, I wanted to cuddle the Wynn Jones Memorial Bowl, you know what I mean?
You learned the name, so you might as well.
Yeah.
It may not have happened for you this year, but I don't doubt that next season you'll be back stronger than ever with your main man, the manager, Paul. Hey, did you see his suit?
Hey, mate, he was looking dapper, quite fly, like me, mate. I'm telling you. Listen, guys, don't forget you can catch Park Life every single Sunday right here on Slash Football. And listen, make sure you follow Manny and the boys. All their stuff is in the link in the description below. Here on Fresh Cut Grass, we're all about bringing you the freshest in grassroots football. That's right, new teams every single week. And this week, we got a debut for you. That's right, one of our new favourite teams, United London FC.
Hey, Dave, there's something different about this team, man.
What's that?
They don't have a manager. It's actually very weird, man. Their fans are in charge. In fact, their fans pick a team each week from the dugout, man. They call the shots.
Hey, what? So what you're saying? The actual armchair fans actually have a say?
Well, yeah, man. Every week, right, they get to pick their team using their official app, man.
What? Mate, that's absolute madness. Does it actually work, or is it just an absolute calamity?
Mate, it's a working dream. Check this out.
If you remember, Sean did score a free kick from this, the same sort of spot, really, against London Cranes. Can you do the same here? Yeah. You can! Sean picks that one up, shoots some distance. Oh, bottom corner, great goal. Sean Bellard making that two goals in two games, and both of those goals coming from outside the box. Hits a banger. Oh! Hits an absolute screamer. Absolute scenes here from United London. Think David Beckham, think Greece. Look at this. Steps up. Just into the corner of the net there. Good through ball there, but Billy's got a hell of a lot to do, but he skins one. He's going to cross it in. He's got Corley and Trey in the middle. Oh, he's cut inside, and he's fired it. That's a fantastic goal. Pick that one up on the halfway line. Oh, with an absolute worldie. He's banged that. As soon as he left his boot, that one was flying in. A fantastic finish there.
What a goal. What a goal. Love that. That was a beautiful strike.
So Sam Ranch just putting that into the danger area. Not a good enough clearance away. But Scotty Truman just gets his knee over that. Fantastic strike. And that was an absolute rocket.
Hey, I'm buzzing for the next game already, mate.
You know what? You are in luck. The boys are in a cup final this coming Tuesday in the Essex Alliance Premier Division Cup at Dagenham and Redbridge's ground.
Hey, listen, guys. If you're a new fan of these guys like I am, don't forget you can vote for who's going to be in the starting lineup. Who's going to start the final on Tuesday night. And we'll be bringing you all the action from that final live and direct on Fresh Cut Grass next week. Mate, what a show. Hey, I love the end of the season. So many celebrations.
It is the best, man. I will be bringing you all the best ones right here on Fresh Cut Grass every Saturday.
Hey, listen, guys, don't forget to go and subscribe to all of the great channels in today's episode. The details will be in the description below.
And let us know in the comments below who you want to see on Fresh Cut Grass next time.
Hey, I've been Cheeky Sport Dave.
My name's Cheeky Sport Joe.
And we're out.
Come on!